Hello and welcome to an Affinity Revolution tutorial. My name is Ezra Anderson, and today we're going to make the colors pop in this photo. If you'd like to follow along with the same image that I'll be using, I've included a download link in the video description. To make the colors pop in this picture, the first thing we're going to do is apply a vibrance adjustment layer. To do this, we'll come to the adjustments icon and then scroll down and select vibrance. A vibrance adjustment layer allows you to saturate the most muted colors in your picture. To see this, we just need to bring the vibrance slider up. To see how this adjustment is affecting our picture, I'm going to exit out of this dialog box and then check it off and on inside the layers panel. The next adjustment we're going to apply is an HSL adjustment. The shortcut to apply this is Command or Control U. With this adjustment, we can saturate all of the colors in our picture. All you need to do is bring up the saturation slider. Just be careful not to bring the slider up too high, or the colors in your picture will start to look a little strange. I'm going to reset this HSL adjustment so our picture is looking normal again. If you want even more control over which colors you're saturating in your photo, you can change the HSL adjustment from master to any of these color channels. Let's go into the red channel so we can target how saturated the reds will be in this picture. As I bring up the saturation slider, you'll notice that only the reds are being affected. Next, I'm going to come into the yellows channel. Then we can target exactly how saturated the yellows become. We can continue this process and go through each color channel to target exactly how saturated that color is in the picture. When you're satisfied with how saturated your picture is, you can exit out of the HSL adjustment. Finally, we want to add some brightness and contrast to the picture. There's two ways that we can do this. The first way is to add a brightness and contrast adjustment layer. To do this, all we need to do is come to the adjustments icon and then select brightness and contrast. Then you can bring up the brightness and contrast as much as you want. This adjustment layer is fairly powerful and extremely easy to use, but I want to show you an even more advanced way to target exactly how bright and contrasted your picture becomes. First though, we're going to exit out of this brightness and contrast and then delete it by pressing delete on the keyboard. Then we're going to apply a curves adjustment layer by pressing Command or Control M. Using the curves adjustment layer, we're going to click and drag somewhere up here on the spline and bring it up. As we bring the spline up, we're making our picture brighter. And because we're bringing this part of the spline up, we're particularly targeting the highlights. If we come down here, then we'll be targeting the shadows in the picture. Rather than making the shadows brighter though, let's make them darker. We can do this by clicking and dragging to bring the spline down. At first glance, the curves adjustment just seems like a more complicated brightness and contrast adjustment. But although it is more difficult, it gives you greater flexibility. Now we can target exactly how dark the shadows become and exactly how bright the highlights become. Just click and drag on these circles to move them up and down to target exactly how bright and dark the colors in your picture become. That's looking good to me, so I'm going to exit out of my curves adjustment. If you ever want to go back and refine any of your adjustments, just double-click on their icon over here. Then you can continue refining the adjustment inside this dialog box and exit out whenever you're done. You might also decide one of your adjustments is a little too strong. In that case, you can always lower the opacity of the layer by clicking and dragging on the word opacity. To see a before and after, just click on the top layer and then hold down Shift and click on the first adjustment layer that you made. Then we can turn them all off to see the original picture and turn them back on to see our photo with its new popping colors. You now have all the skills you need to give your pictures beautiful colors.